This morning I made an error and didn't turn on the recording, so I'm just going to do a voiceover for you. So we began this session by looking at what our intention is for the session, and it's assessing your body's wisdom. And I did a reading from your textbook by Kripalu Yoga by Richard Falls. On page 183, Richard Falls talks about your body wisdom. Your body is constantly speaking to you, communicating what it needs to be happy and healthy through its language of intuitive urges and feelings. And then he further goes and talks about a felt sense. Assessing the wisdom of your body is not difficult. You simply feel what is true for you, momentarily giving up the need for things and making that make logical sense. And he calls this a felt sense. And because your body's wisdom can easily be negated, which we often override by our conscious mind, understanding its source as its adaptive unconsciousness, an aspect of psyche under scrutiny by research psychologists, may help you to trust its guidance. The adaptive unconsciousness is set of sophisticated mental processes that operate below the threshold of your consciousness. And further, to have a better understanding of this, consider, in certain tasks such as recognizing faces and sensing danger or opportunity, detecting complex patterns in the environment, the adaptive unconsciousness outperforms your conscious mind, so learning to trust it. While a bit mysterious because we've lost touch with our felt sense, the body's wisdom is not mystical or infallible. It is instinctive and primal, even primitive, along with an autonomic knowing. We surely need conscious decision-making to meet the mix of biological, psychological, and social needs we face daily. But if you can cut off from the simple and direct wisdom of your own body, you've lost an important compass that through your journey towards a greater health and wellness. So learning to assess your body's wisdom is part of the practice of yoga. So go ahead and find an easy seated position. Notice the heaviness of your thighs and start to let go of all the things that your body tells you it's supposed to do. And start to notice what your body is doing and what it wants to do. Start to connect to your breath. Taking deep inhalations, deep exhalations. Finding that three-part breath, expanding around the rib cage, lifting gently in the shoulder girdle, and then allowing that all to recede on the exhalation. Take a moment to establish a clear intention for your session today. Repeat that in your mind's eye. Hold on to that intention. We'll unite voices in the sound of one ohm, taking a deep inhale. Om. Find your way on your back. Start to let go Feel the weight of your body emptying to the mat. Draw your knees into your chest. With your hands on your knees, start to roll your knees out, making big circles through your hip sockets. Feel free to rock side to side to massage the back. And move them in the other direction. And hug your knees into your chest. Placing your hands at the back of your thighs, start to rock your body front to back. Just a few more times. And then land up on your sits bones and let your feet go as wide as your mat with your knees bent. Place your hands behind you, roll the shoulders down, lift up through the chest, and then start to send your knees side to side. Feel free to lift the hips up gently as you move side to side. And eventually, you'll land with your knees on one side, and you'll place your hands on your thighs.
is just awareness of the body. You go ahead and take one leg back, come off the ball of that foot, and then just rock forward the back a little bit. And then let it settle back. Soften the knee just a bit. Keep pressing the heel away. And then lifting that back leg if you'd like to. Keep the energy moving up out of the stable hip. The lower hip, and then take the arm on that. Exhale, bring the knee to the elbow, inhale, and open out, look straight to the back, come to your neck. Exhale, inhale, exhale. Hold here. And bring the hand down, bring the knee down, and stabilize your chin.
Your heels go down. You can keep your hands down here. This is fine. Lengthen through your
go to the balance here, keep the belly energy lifting so you're not loading the knees. Can you breathe? And bring those arms down. And plant your heels down. And then relax your belly over your thighs, just draping it over. Move the hands to the shins and lengthen your trunk, lifting it up so as if it was a table on it. Serve some tea off it. Roll the shoulders down. Notice what's happening. And then notice what happens as you take your arms out in a T position. What's happening to the belly? Can you create a little more lift in the belly to stabilize it? Feel the ground with your feet root down and lift your trunk upwards, finding mountain, nice and tall mountain, drop the shoulders. And bring awareness to the length of the spine. Sacrum and roll the shoulder back. And then reach forward, nice long trunk, into a triangle shavasana. Bring that arm down, open the side body, nice length through the body. Reach away with that top arm and then lift it upwards. And breathe. It's like moving the mountain to the side. The top arm could go over the head if you've gone there and your breath stops. Just return to an easier way of existing. What is your body telling you? top arm comes alongside that top hip. Bend your front knee, bring your forearm down, and then kind of activate the musculature on the underbody here and your armpits, are not dumped into that shoulder. Lift up out of the waist. Good. Now you could stay right here. Pay attention to what your body's telling you. So there is always more. Okay, so you could take the arm straight up. You could let it frame your head. Feel some energy in that back leg, pressing and opening the hip to the side of the mat.
Close the eyes.
open the hip to the side of the mat. Reach the upper arm away. Maybe it goes straight up. Maybe it goes over the head. And you're going to place right beside the stick it. What did your body say that I want to do something a little different? And bring those blocks in if you'd like to. Back foot's going to scooch in just a little bit, square off those hips some more. And you could put your blocks up on the top of their side if you want. Send your front foot back foot forward. Nice length in your trunk. So the back leg's arm is going to cross over, and you can move the block in closer and use that as a tool. But if you're there and you're rounded through your back, you've kind of lost it, you're just weighing more effort than your body wants to give in. You'll access a lot more strength and ability to be flexible if you lift that trunk and just go into an easier place and place your other hand to your sacrum. Squeeze your inner thighs together, start to rotate through your hip, your ribs, your shoulder. And maybe the arm goes up. Big toe now, the big toe. the other is your bolster and sit on it. Or you could take a blanket and roll up your back and kind of create this long edge here. So you bring your heels up on the edge and you're using the blanket. Find rooting down and just lift upwards so that you're not dumping down into those knees. You want to feel like you're lifting lightly. And bring your hands to the heart. And start to slowly descend. So pay attention. Does your body say, hey, that's all I got to do? Okay. If you've got more, you can. Go deeper, deeper, deeper. Elbows to the inside of the thighs, lifting up out of the waist here. So some people have easy ankle flexibility and core strength, and they have the ability to just simply be down on their heels. All right, so if you can, okay, but you're not more light because you can. It's just about being where you are today. So assess your body's messages. If you try it and your body says no, listen. You get this one body in this lifetime. Slowly descending. happening. So you feel, you're going to feel your pectoral muscles, your chest muscles drawn towards each other, and you're going to feel your lat muscle, which is a big muscle of your back, drawn down, and pulling your trunk up, come into all fours. Handprint forward of your shoulders, so get those hands just forward of your shoulders will help you with the alignment of the standing dog. Let your hands be as wide as your shoulders. And then flex your toes. Come into that neutral spine already. Lift your knees from the mat, send your hips back, and then lift those hips up. Not changing the feet, they should be in a good place. And then bring awareness first to the hands. Your shoulders, are they rolling down? Is your spine extended? The knees can have a bend in them, you can let your heels go down. You do not need to touch the ground with your heels. It's not the order of the posture that you do that. It's not a requirement. So these are, this is an inversion, so if you need to pull away because you're on your flow or maybe issues in the head. toes. Just notice what's happening in your body. Thank you. steady the body to guide you.